Valens Research, Uniform Financial Analytics.
Lowe's biggest issue is everybody wants Lowe's to be Home Depot. Right? And actually, it's really useful if we look here. I'm going to take you to a separate page for Lowe's before we actually go and talk about Lowe's itself and what the market's expecting. What this chart here is the ROAs of companies and the valued asset primes of companies, right? A company and its peers. Basically, what we're looking at here is we're trying to understand there is a very strong relationship between the return a company generates and the multiple that company trades at relative to its asset base. Just if you think about it intuitively, when you clean up all the accounting noise and you're looking at the real returns of the business, if my cost of capital, right, and the cost of capital right now, the real cost of capital in the market for these companies is around 5%. If my cost of capital is 5% and I have a 5% return, what should the multiple that my company trades at relative to its asset base? Roughly 1x, right? I need, my investors need a 5% return in my business, and my business is producing a 5% return. They will pay book value for my business. As I generate a 10% return, right, they'll pay 2x. As I generate a 15% return, they'll pay 3x. As I generate a 20% return, they'll pay 4x. You can see in this chart that relationship exists, right? You might have an outlier, like say eBay, which is really not actually a peer of these companies. But if I look besides that, there is clearly a slope here of higher ROA leads to higher asset growth. Now, if I look, right, I'm turning on and off Home Depot here. Here's where Home Depot is, right? It's at the top of that line. Here's where Lowe's is, right? Lowe's is also here. Lowe's is also priced above what the trend line should be for what its valuation should be, considering how good of a business it is. The reason why, because everybody wants Lowe's to be Home Depot. What Home Depot has done every single year since the Great Recession is Home Depot has successfully improved its ROA every single year. Look at this. Since 2010, ROA from Home Depot has gone from 9% to 12% to 17% to 25% every single year. Now, Lowe's started doing that, right, in terms of what they were doing, right? Lowe's started with this fundamental trend for the business. But the reality is what it actually had happen was thereafter that plateau happened, right? It didn't continue to improve. What happened was really after 2016, returns have leveled off. And yet what the market is pricing in for Lowe's is for continued growth, right? What the market thinks is going to happen for Lowe's is they're gonna have returns ramp further, just like Home Depot did, but also they think that just like how Home Depot has been able to grow a bit more, Lowe's is actually going to accelerate growth. When in actuality, Lowe's has been shrinking. And so for Lowe's, what's so telling is, and this is what's also incredibly useful about this app, is what we can do is we can not just look at a company, but now because a company and its peers actually have comparable data, we can compare a company to its peers and understand where the performance trends are of that company and its peers to understand where we're seeing names that are potentially mispriced because their performance is better or worse than we're realizing, and where we're seeing companies that are actually better or worse than peers in a way that we wouldn't understand otherwise.
Valens Research, the world's leading source for uniform financial analytics.